everyone, it's Nuna Gamer, and today we're playing a new game actually. It's Pentiment. I've heard about this game from a mortal on Twitter, and yeah, I checked it out. It seems like a story-based choices and stuff like that. It's set in the medieval times, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, should be interesting, a completely different kind of game. Let's go! Let's check it out. No, I like the stylized fonts and should be okay. Okay, I don't like doing these two books, but I guess in principio erat verbum, et verbum erat apud Deum, et Deus erat verbum. And then I can't read that, so we'll scrap that. So, is this what I'm going to do today? I mean, it's true that there were a period in your story that they try to destroy books and stuff like that. Well, is this what I'm supposed to do? So this chapter is an artist's mind, Andreas, and the apple said to me, Andreas, I don't want you to distract the sisters in the library. I need you to finish this commission by the end of April. We said that it's April 1518, I think, so keep your conversation with brother Piero to a minimum. Okay, so I need to choose, okay. Isn't that much earlier than you were expecting? Yes, you told me I had until the Ides of May. And he's not going to pay you anymore, is he? He has no appreciation for the cost of your sweat. Socrates. I the yield of labor should not be measured in coin, but in personal satisfaction and self-improvement. Yeah, but exactly. The personal satisfaction doesn't put much food on the table, though, does it? Prester John, how did you reply to the abbot, Andreas? I said I will do my best to get it done by the end of April. With discipline and mindfulness, we will persevere. If you don't kill yourself striving to meet the abbot's unreasonable expectations. What she said, what's the point in burning your candle to the knob for the idiot abbot's sake? Despite the abbot's ire, you must endure. Soon you will have finished both the abbot's work as well as your masterpiece. And then you will return to Nuremberg, where marriage and your new life as a master await you. Yes, marriage to someone he has never met, hardly ideal. Well, the alternative is becoming a philosopher. Oh Jesus, then you should definitely get married. Is she pretty at least? Growing late, the wheel of time stops for no man, Andreas. I fear you must leave us. Ah, true, your majesty. Will you visit us again soon? Hopefully, but it's out of my control. As are many things, trust in Providence. Grobian, please see Andreas safely home. Of course, your majesty. Until next time, Andreas. Until next time, Your Majesty. Pay no mind to the other fools, Andreas. I never do. Good morning, Ursula. Good morning. Time to get up. Yeah, I'll never get that fast up in the morning. The Baron. April 1518. Quests. A few more pages back to the abbey. Okay. I should clean this up. The Picatrix, Key of Solomon, the Heptameron. Prior Fenning keeps... Okay, I was reading. Giving me all of these books to read, okay. Go to bed now. Quests, let me see. Prime hour 6. Another day, another few pages for the abbot and hopefully a few for myself. I need to get across town and then up to the abbey so I can start work at the scriptorium. Okay, so my first quest is to get to the abbey and start work at the scriptorium. Okay, let's go then. Get in the house, let's go. Clara? Good morning, Andreas. Did you sleep well? Quite well, actually, thank you. Oh, I'm so glad to hear it. Anyway, I know how you'll be off to the abbey, so I packed you some food. Oh, that's nice. Almonds, cheese, and some of the rye you like from the Albans. Otto wanted me to ask you to join him for dinner at the abbey. Otto stopped by, said Eva. Yes, around dawn. Here you are, Andreas. That's too kind of you, Clara, many thanks. Master Andreas, if it wouldn't be too much to... Would it be too much trouble if you paid the next month rent today? And if we raised it by 2 groschen? I have to ask, but we're behind on our taxes to the abbey, 2 months behind. Peter's losing his hair over it, even more than usual, I mean. Of course. Oh, bless you, Andreas. Many Saint Luke watch over you today. Speaking of Saint Luke, how is it your master be coming along? It's been 2 months now, hasn't it? Slowly, I'm afraid. Most of my days are spent doing work for the abbey. It's only during the divine office that Prior Ferenc allows me to work on my masterpiece. A reasonable restriction, although going. The city council doesn't require to become a master. I'm making it mostly to show clients for my own sake. And yes, when I do finish, I will go back to Nuremberg, where I will marry and open a workshop on my own. From Nuremberg to a university and now traveling the world as an artist. What a life you have ahead of you, Master Andreas. Yes, I suppose it does feel like I'm starting a new chapter in my life after some wandering. It must be rather frightening, starting all over again. It is, but I know now this is what I want to do. This will be remembered, okay. Now maybe people will get to decide that. Certainly not anyone in Tassing. Anyway, I don't know anything about art, but I've seen you sketching such beautiful things in your little book. Your masterpiece must be wonderful. It's getting there. Hard work will get you out all of the way. That's what my father used to say. God rest his soul. Now I have to get back to my own work. Have a good day at the Abbey, Andreas. I will see you after Vespers for supper. Not tonight, but thank you. Kraus the Drucker invite me over for supper. Of course. Please say hello to the Druckers for us. Of course. Until later, Clara. Hello. Morning, Andreas. Morning, Bjork. How is it going? You working today? Just taking a rest for a bit. Dad's still in the field. He hit a big rock with the plow and it took me Lord knows how long to pull it out. Okay. You off to the abbey? Every day but Sunday. Right, thank you. Thank God for Sundays. It smells like storm is coming now. Just smells like fresh alpine air to me. You've been traveling too much. Where was it you spent your wander yare for maybe? In yare, it's like a year. Yare, it's year, so in German, so okay. So I guess you're wandering years. Before you come to Tassing, you came to Tassing. Basel. Flanders. Or Italy. I mean, let's go with Italy. Italy, Florence for a while, but Venice and Milan as well. How long will that take? 10-15 years? I don't think I have that long, a big jog. What did you spend all the time in Italy doing anyway? Other than art, I mean. Hedonist? Oh, no. Craftsman? Bookworm? No. Yeah, let's go, why not? Businessman. Learning how to run a business. The art will come with time, but how to manage finances, deal with clients. I have to secure my place in the world when I become a master. That's going to come from coin. You're a smart man, Andreas. Wish I could say anyone in my family knew anything about business. Most years we barely have enough to get by. The peasants not, I suppose. Anyway, I have to get going. See you later, Andreas. Until later. Il Peter. God bless you, huh? Andreas. Oh, yes, Andreas. This weather's been awful. This town's gone for shit since my days. I don't think the townsfolk can do much about the weather. Were things very different when you were young? As different as beer and... Okay. The old apple didn't bother us much about our customs. It didn't mind if we left a little offering to... Carta, I guess it's another kind of divinity to keep the probably a polytheistic divinity to keep the skies clear, the weather fair. Matthias knew that Christ was in our hearts, even if the white lady's name was on our lips. The church ran all the services of pagan gods, Il Peter. Oh, yeah. What sort of old customs? I thought St. Moritz protecting Tassing. The bastard Albert may not like it, but some of us keep the traditions alive. Like the old widow Ottilia. I won't mention that at the Abbey. What does tradition entail? I should go. God bless you. Okay. Okay, I can do this direction. I guess I'll have to go the other way. Okay. Town Commons, let's go. Andres. Hello, Andreas. Hello. And this Smithy. It's so much smaller than the one he uses at the Abbey. Can go there. Wait, let me go this way first. Martin, please, Veronica says. Can you give me a hand here? What do you want? I'm keeping an eye on them. That looks a lot like standing there and doing nothing. Eddie says, Martin, for Christ's sake, help your cousin. Ah, morning, Andreas. Excuse us. One of the fence rails fell and the ship started hopping at. Is there something I can do to help? Have you ever handled the ships before? Well, good point. Oh, look, there's something going on up on Turner's place. Who's that on the horse? Looks rich. I don't know, Martin, but Lucky is giving him an earful. I haven't seen Lucky that worked up since Peter and Sierra's wedding when John and Paul is bent down. Knock two of my men's teeth out, and you don't want to feel the strength behind a stone man's own anger. You think it's a noble? He looks really rich. Oh, he's obsessed. Damn it, Martin. Stay out of trouble for once. What, Aunt Eddie? Behave yourself. Don't we have enough to deal with right now? Andreas, if you wouldn't mind moving your skinny little body up the road, we need to get these ships under control. Of course. See you later. Good luck. Let's go. Klaus. Oh. Morning, Andreas. How's it going? Okay, I could read it already. Blah, blah. Morning, Klaus. Another day at the Abbey. Another few hours to work on my masterpiece. Good to hear. You still coming for supper tonight? Mary and Bert would love to see you. You really need to see these new woodcuts I have for an Italian edition of Till Eulenspiegel. I didn't realize Father Thomas let you print books in Italian. Come on, Andreas, is not that strict. I know he's just trying to protect people from... adventure stories of questionable moral. He doesn't mind those so much, actually. No? As long as they don't get too carnal. So, supper tonight after Vespers? Of course. Thank you. Great. I'll tell Marie and Bertha you're coming. See you then. See you later. Okay. I guess this is the Abbey. Thomas. Bless Master Maler. I hope your week is going well. Thank you, Father. It's going quite well. I'm just on my way up the hill to get to work. Good, good, Andreas. I don't recall seeing you at Sunday morning mass. You understand how important it is for your salvation that you receive Holy Communion, don't you? Oh, yes, I apologize, Father Thomas. You didn't have to make a promise to me, but our salvation is contingent on the... Oh my, what a blessed day to receive such a illustrious visitor. Master Maler, this is Lawrence, Baron of Vogel, a great lord from the countryside near Worms. Lawrence, good to see you, Father Thomas. It is nice to be remembered fondly. I only wish all of your neighbors were as welcoming. I guess, he's the one you pay taxes to or something? Well, yes. What brings you back to our little town? My wife and I were returning from a trip to Venice. We spent a few days in Innsbruck, Austria. And it was terribly dull. I mean, it has a certain charm common to these Alpine cities, but the place is crumbling with nobles for the Emperor's diet. The Emperor's? What? Was he there? Did you see him? Oh, briefly, but it was sitting for a portrait at the time, quite lovely. I didn't want to bother him or the painter. Who was the artist, my lord? I'm sure you know him, an older man from Nuremberg, with enough of a reputation to paint the Emperor. Andreas says, you must mean Albert Dürer. As a fellow Nuremberger and artist, I admire his wisdom, acumen, as much as his talent. Well, two artists from Nuremberg in a week. What are the odds? Anyway, my wife wanted to stay a bit longer in Innsbruck, and I decided to ride ahead to make a visit to Kirsau. I heard the father of Matthias died shortly after my last visit, of course. A great loss for the abbey. Loss, and for us all. Indeed, by good fortune, I recently came across a copy of the Historia Tassie. He was reading during my last visit. Father Matthias was hoping to find a second copy to corroborate the contents of the first. It contains some fascinating details about the history of this place. I'm afraid they may even cause a bit of scandal. But I must be off. There will be time enough to discuss Tassing's past later. I commissioned a manuscript from the abbey through Father Gernot, and I have come to check on its progress. Okay, that's why zero then. Oh my lord, if you have come to see your manuscript, you should speak with young Master Maler here. It is an honor to meet you, my lord. Andreas is a journeyman artist from Nuremberg for the next few months. He's also helping in the abbey's scriptorium. A Nuremberg artist working in abbey scriptorium? In 1518? Oh, we should talk, Andreas. I must know the story. Of course, my lord. It will be an honor. Wonderful. It's so rare to find someone in the countryside who knows anything about art. Thank you for the introduction, Father Thomas. Come to supper at the abbey tonight. Okay, of course, I have another appointment, but yeah. I'm inviting you to the abbot's table. We will see you then. Miklaus, I'm dismounting. Run ahead of us and take the horse to the abbey's guest house. I'd like to take my time talking with Master Maler. I'll meet you there. At once, my lord. Lawrence. So then, a journeyman from Nuremberg. Forgive me for saying so, but you seem a little old to not yet be a master. Are you unmarried? No, I'm not married. But in truth, I came to my vocation later than my father and brothers. I was in university for a number of years at Erfurt. Erfurt? Wonderful. The same university as Martin Luther. Have you read his works? Tremendous mind. He says things about the church that he should have been said years ago. Might get him into trouble, but he's a brave, brilliant man. Wait, you may have... even met him, did you? You must tell me. Oh no, he was a few years ahead of me. Still, his ideas do seem fascinating. Agree, wholeheartedly. I simply must meet him if I get the chance. I wonder if the good brothers of the abbey have heard of him. Perhaps they've even read this list of 95 theses against the church. Father Matthias was not above having a lively debate. I hope Father Gernot does not disappoint in that regard. But enough about Luther for now. Tell me about your university studies. My family is merely wealthy enough to have provided me with all of the books and tutors a child could dream of. I love all knowledge from Aristotle to Cicero to Ficino and Erasmus and everyone in between and yet to come. I may have misjudged the Baron. It seems as well read as my university, as any university student. In truth, I am simply happy to speak with another well-educated man. Now then, did you earn your doctorate? No, I didn't. Only a master's degree. I started working towards a doctorate, but didn't finish. Oh, that's a shame. Well, what was your area of study? A theology, no. I will say Pirolo. It goes well with studying business. Low, I suppose I thought I could practice in Nuremberg. I never had much interest in the subject, honestly. A bit dull for my thesis. Besides, the Empire is such a mess of jurisdiction. Bavarian law, Rhenish law, Franconian law, nonsense. I'd rather use my money to pay someone who studied the nonsense than learn it myself. Ottilia, you! If I had any faith, I would have prayed you'd never show your face here again. Curse you, Lawrence Rothvogel. Perched dogs tearing you to pieces will be too kind of a fate. These rustic communities display a shocking lack of hospitality, don't you think? What was that about? Who knows? By the time I finish guessing, the old crone will probably be dead. Yeah, of course you don't know. Well, what's your early time in university? Every student must study the trivium and quadrivium, yes? Did you have a favorite subject? We'll go with logician. Logic, geometry, and arithmetic. Quite interesting for an artist. Was Aristotle's Organon the foundation of your study? Yes, the Organon for logic and Euclid's Element for geometry. But the past few centuries have yielded the wonderful new texts on logic. Peter Abelard provided the foundation of scholastic philosophy and established the primacy of Aristotle's work. The Englishman William of Ockham gave us the same logic, arguing nominalism against Platonic realism. And of course, Thomas Aquinas gave us the tools to employ both faith and reason in the pursuit of truth. All monks and friars, of course, a great deal of work to force Aristotle to fit within the church's reasons of truth. Is that so wrong? I question that this great man should have had to wrestle logic into what the church established by faith and force. And your other studies, was there anything else you excelled at? Ah, there's the abbey, finally. I have good memories of this place and of Father Matthias. I was sad to hear of his passing. How did you come to know him? How did you come to know of Curaçao at all? My family have been patrons of Curaçao for, okay, I don't know how many generations. Some years ago, I heard that Curaçao still had a wonderful library and artisans. Professional artists have taken over most manuscript productions, so I was shocked to find an active scriptorium here. Commissioned a manuscript, maybe it's the one that he's working at, a manuscript to Father Gernot a year ago. I thought I would stop by and check on the progress. Wait, are you the artist working on it? It's a prayer book with 20 illustrations. I know the work, but no, I do know the artist well, the venerable Brother Piero. How venerable. He has still his wits and his skill, if that's what concerns you. Brother Piero has an incredible talent with color. Then I very much look forward to seeing it. May Klaus tend to the horses and the baggage. I'm heading up to the abbey. Yes, my lord. Nuns. Quite unusual for a Benedictine house to have monks and nuns, even if they are separated. The church closed most of them centuries ago. But then Curaçao is a place of thought time in more ways than one. Do you know Mother Cecilia? She seemed to recognize you. We are acquainted, yes. Let's leave it at that. Ah, you must be Father Gernot. I am Lawrence Baron of... Yes, the Baron of Rothvogel. So wonderful to have you here again. We actually did meet on your last visit. Ah, if you say so. I'm not good with remembering faces. Please forgive me, my lord. But I wasn't expecting you for another few days. Yes, I know, but I rode ahead. I just couldn't wait to see my manuscript. I'm sure it's no trouble. Well, yes, I mean, no, it's no trouble. Did you want to see it now? Oh, in a moment. I could do with a bit of refreshment, though. May I grab something from the kitchen? Yes, yes, certainly, my lord. I will meet you there. Andreas, I don't know what you are doing with the Baron, but I need you in the scriptorium now. Of course, Father. I'm eager to get to work. Ja. Okay, I guess a new is to get paid. Let's explore a bit. I will get lost in here. Saint Luke, the patron of artists, is also the patron of healers. Sai leggere l'italiano? Can you read Italian? I will get lost here, trying to explore everything. A dance of that moral, Father Matthias had it painted a few years before his death. It's beautiful. The abbot's house, okay, let's go. Okay, that went well. Is this a bell? I've seen this before in astronomy and medical charts. What's this one for? Two wheels. The top wheel has a Greek letter and holes cut out to reveal Latin letters underneath. And the other edge of the lower wheel is divided into four sections, each bearing an elemental symbol. 24 holes, enough to cover all letters in the Greek and Latin alphabets. A quarter turn to the upper disc allows a different ornamental symbol with the top of lower disc. Litter av natt. Until then. Oh, brother Piero is here. What do you want, Andreas? A book. The Indermauer manuscript. The Book of Hours. Your hair looks messy today. Did you get enough sleep? What do you mean? I mean, did you sleep alone or... Why do you want to know? It would be nice to have something to think about during the divine reading. Have you considered the Lord? You really are a cloud of no sunny day, Andreas. Could I just get the book? Oh, that's all the way upstairs. Can't you get by without it? No, I'm sorry, but I really can't. I need to reference it for my work. Really? My feet hurt and the stairs are steep. I'm just going to ask Illuminata to get it. Sister Illuminata, Andreas needs a book and he's being inappropriate with him. Sister Illuminata, I'd like to borrow the Indermauer manuscript, the Book of Hours. Yes, I've overheard. Here, please return it promptly. It's interesting the fact that the sisters are the keepers of all the manuscripts. The contrast of colors is also quite nice, rich and beautiful on their own, but not quite overpowering the scene. It doesn't feel right. I don't know why. It's an excellent interpretation of someone else's work. What do you mean? My son, you're copying the illustration from the Indermar manuscript almost exactly. So, what's wrong with that? Haven't I improved on it? Aesthetically, yes, it's wonderful, but I feel you have not given much thought to what it represents. It's November. I mean, it's actually November. In November, we show peasants leading the pigs into the forest to forage on our corn before the slaughter. Andreas, the peasants here are no longer allowed to forage acorns in the forest. Many great lords and abbots across the empire are forbidden it, even Father Gernot. So, again, that's not a good art. That's not the way November is. Art is illusion, storytelling, but in the most subtle form, sublime form. These images illuminate a path to a truth. There is no place for the monastic scriptory anymore. In truth, this room is a place out of time. I'll admit I'm still fond of the old styles of lettering and illumination, but even in my youth, I knew it could not last. The creation of books, of art, is no longer the province of monasteries, and so be it. More people will be able to write, more will be able to read, and so the wing be brought to truth. I think there will always be a place for artists like you and Brother Edok. And Brother Guy. It's kind of you to say so, Andreas, but you need not to be concerned for me. I have lived a long life and happy to have served the Lord. When it calls for me, I am ready. Andreas, what was that noise? Oh, I'm sorry, Sister Luminata, I knocked a bowl of paint onto the floor. But then Prior Ferenc came in, wrote in one of these books, slammed it closed and left. Also, you see that? You saw it. He was in such a hurry, I don't think he even noticed me. He was slamming boots shut. Prior Ferenc should know better than that. Some of these manuscripts are quite delicate. Which is why books should not be taken out of the library, as it is necessary for divine reading or work in the scriptorium. Oh, that reminds me, there are a few more books I've been wanting to borrow. You can't be serious, you want more books? I think Ferenc has given you more than enough. I don't ask for those books, he just gives them to me and asks for my opinion. That's between the two of you. My concern is only for the books. I can't give them out to just anyone. I'm not just anyone. You're right, you're not. You're not a member of this community. The brothers have their vows and vocation to guide their conscience. You could just wander off without of the library if I loan it to you. I take offense to that. I may love these books, but I will not run off with them. My concern for the books does not end at the library door, nor does my responsibility. Please understand that. Now, if you'll excuse me. Wait, what's all this fuss about Lawrence or Old Vogel? Why is Prior Ferenc so nervous? Lawrence? I didn't know you were familiar enough with the man to use his Christian name. Anyway, I haven't dealt with him personally, but the prior and father both have. I only know that he's purchased a number of our most valuable manuscripts over the years. And he paid enough to help the abbey when we needed it. I can remember, you know, I have my own responsibility to attend to. How about this, Andreas? If you help me recover some missing books, I'll tell you what I know about the Baron. Of course. I'll help in any way I can. Thank you. It's for the good of the abbey. Where should I begin? Out there, when you and your cohort have currently strewn books around the scriptorium. I will tell you what books I'm looking for, find them, and return them to me. First book are the two volumes of the Aeneid, okay. Reddish covers, 14 inches by 10 inches, 3 inches thick. Likely, the we ordinary women are merely tools in the tales of men. We can never be the protagonists of our own stories. No woman is exempt from that. From the Empress to a nun, it is our lot. I suppose I understand now why you are not fond of the Aeneid. It's fine poetry for men. chi è questo cavaliere che domanda battaglia?
Qui gli rispose.
Ma raccostatosi a lui più vicino, lo riconobbe.
The beauty of this book truly believes its ridiculous content. I'm surprised the abbey owns a copy.
We don't. It belongs to Amedea Rusco of Lugano. It's a Venetian edition that's quite valuable. He loaned to us a few years ago and was subsequently lost, and the abbot has received 3 letters about it. I've certainly seen the brothers enjoying it. That book is not appropriate reading for Benedictine monks. A baby is sold to pirates, raised a servant, then lives a life of adventure, wooing princesses and fighting in tournaments. You forgot the best part. In the end, Gwerin learns he has royal blood, the son of a duke. He reigns as a king and dies a pious hermit. What's not to love? Benedictines should be dreaming of a reconciliation with our Lord, not lusty adventures.
Fantasy leads to temptation. Temptation has led to the downfall of many men and women.
Well, this looks like France. This looks like French, so I don't think I will understand anything, so. Well, I get the general sense of a paragraph, but yeah.
Thank you.
Let's go. Now then, Baron Rothbogel, quickly. I need to finish up here soon. The Baron is quite wealthy, quite educated, and loves fine art. I think it's clear why he enjoys your company. Most of his peers don't share his passion for modern thinking, nor are they as interested in art. You are a rarity, Andreas Maler, an artist with a university education. You may not be of high birth, but whatever the Baron's faults may be, he chooses to fraternize with common people, sometimes with unpleasant consequences. Yes, but I can't say anything more than that. It was a tragic affair. No one at the Abbey wanted to deal with it then, and certainly no one wants to dig up the past now. Should I be concerned for my safety, sister? I can say I don't know Baron Rothbogel much more than you do, Andreas. But there is an inherent danger to walking in the shadow of a powerful man. Just be careful. Well, I must be off to Mass. Thank you again for your help, Andreas. We are standing in the oldest part of the Abbey, and like any old place, it has its share of secrets. Good day, Andreas. God be with you. That's the bell for sext. The brothers will be sitting down for dinner soon. I should see if Otto is around and still wants to eat with me. So this is the secret passage. Okay, so I won't use it now, but I know where it is, okay. Very interesting. So I have to go to the crypt. Okay. Okay, interesting.